Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome back to the video of the Roshan Gramption, and today I'm bringing you guys my weekly live reaction for Tokyo Ghoul Raid Chapter 64. And by the way, sorry this wasn't up yesterday. I think the chapter did come out yesterday, but the reason why I couldn't get it up yesterday is because, in all honesty, I'm totally addicted to Berserk. Which, by the way, if you don't know, Berserk is another seinen manga, which is incredibly good. And if you haven't heard of it because you've been living under a rock or for whatever reason, then I highly recommend checking it out. But I was reading that all of yesterday, and I'm totally addicted. So I'm really sorry about that, guys. My bad. I also had some other stuff going on too, and I just didn't really have time to edit a video, but today I do have time, so today we're doing this. And this chapter is called A Devouring Gut. By the way, I heard, not a spoiler, but I heard an indication that apparently we're gonna learn a little bit about V in this chapter, so I'm very excited for that. That could be completely wrong though, so I'm not 100% sure. Anyways, in her interview, Senta Katsuki revealed that she is a ghoul. Footage from the broadcast has gone viral on video streaming sites, and ripples are spreading, of course, that makes sense. If I'm not mistaken, the interview was originally meant to be the announcement of Takatsuki's new novel. No, well, she did announce a novel, but she also announced that she's a freaking ghoul, so. Given that she herself was planning to announce the work, various intelligence articles were paying attention to the event. But to think, they learned that she is a ghoul. By the way, Mr. Ogura, have you read the book? What are your thoughts? No comment. I'd probably have no comment if I read that too, even though I don't know, like, exactly what it's about. I do know what it's sort of about. So I guess, did she reveal to everyone that she's the one-eyed owl? I love that picture down there. She's just, like, casually looking and smiling at the camera. I've been instructed not to talk about it by the higher-ups. Classic. She's really done a number on them, hasn't she? Well, I guess she has. This was actually a pretty good, an interesting move by Takatsuki when you think about it, because it probably threw the CCG really off guard. News that the CCG has taken custody of her for being a ghoul has spread. Many people are making their varied opinions, known to the CCG. I would imagine that this is going to be a very divisive issue, since a lot of people are probably going to be like, kill her because she's a ghoul, and others are probably going to be like, no, she's a great author, don't kill her. Oh, right there, it says about 50-50. The ratio of those who support her and those that call for greater punishment is about 50-50. Interesting. Boss, have you by chance read the thing? You do like your books. Her 10th novel, Beleg, the King. Beleg is the name of a northern European god, another name for Odin, apparently. One that means he who lacks one eye, which means Beleg the King might well mean the one-eyed king. Is that about Kaneki, I wonder? It is a heroic epic. I thought it was about Eto's past. Okay. Anyways, it is a heroic epic detailing how the protagonist, the one-eyed ghoul Nameless, leads his fellow ghouls as their king, flying the flag of rebellion against a world that oppresses his kind. Paints quite a gallant picture of Nameless. If you just read it as a work of fiction, it'd go down pretty easily, no misgivings. The fact that Takatsuki herself is a ghoul, well, the meaning of the story begins to change. In her interview, Takatsuki mentioned how she had addressed the book to her fellow ghouls. Right now, there's no doubt that given the way the work was announced, ghouls will be just as eager as anyone else to read it. The biggest problem is that the human organization of the thing, perhaps modeled after the Washu clan, who knows, it is revealed to be covertly cooperating with the ghouls. Wow, so this is a huge revelation, or rather an indication, because it's not known for sure if the CCG is cooperating with ghouls, but it would be really weird if Ishida did this and they weren't, because this is definitely Takatsuki saying, indicating through a book, that the CCG is cooperating specifically with V, and we don't know if V is necessarily an organization of entirely ghouls, but we know that V has some ghouls, so the fact that Arma was meeting with Kaiko from V in the last chapter means that in some way, the CCG is most likely cooperating with V, and we don't necessarily know, I suppose, if Arma is a member of V, or if he's just representing the CCG in their dealings with V, but at the very least, the CCG is for sure involved with V. It looks like Hoagie is alive, which is nice. I thought she died last chapter. First class Hoagie, please give your report. Oh, did they make it out alive? Oh shit, the Hachikawa squad, tasked with the reconnaissance of Rue Island, is no more. Three of us were killed in action, and the last Mutsuki of the Qs, his condition is unknown. Fuck! No, I knew this was gonna happen, but I'm still fucking pissed. Shit. Oh no, Mutsuki's captured. Mutsuki's just lying there. I see Mutsuki. Damn, okay. So now at this point, it's very likely that Mutsuki is at least going to get tortured. More on that later, though. Good work. I'm glad you made it back. We'll be dispatching a regiment for Rue Island. Wow, they just let her go. That's a huge oversight by Aogiri. The objective will be the annihilation of Aogiri Tree. We will crush those fools with every last ounce of our strength. There's definitely going to be... I think V is going to be involved in this, because V wants to annihilate Aogiri Tree, the CCG wants to annihilate Aogiri Tree, we know there's a connection between the CCG and V, so why wouldn't V be involved in some way? The large-scale key to the operation is the simultaneous maintenance of an offensive and defensive front. We, the Qs, are probably going to be put on the offensive front. We'll be part of the squad that goes ashore onto the island itself, which sort of makes sense because they can regenerate and such. Our mission is to put as many ghouls in the dirt as we can, and also, if possible, save the lost Mutsuki. If any of us, even one, becomes a special class investigator, we'll be able to pay for her medical fees semi-permanently. Damn, okay. Uri is pretty determined to rescue Mutsuki, I can tell. He told us to kill his sister. They're talking about Uri, aren't they? I don't even know if what we're doing is right. We might be stomping all over his memory by blatantly ignoring his last wish. They're ignoring it, okay. But it's also possible that in his last moments, he just wanted to avoid putting a burden on us. He visited her every week without fail. There's no way he could truly ask us to kill her. In his stead, we will continue to pay the fees for his sister's treatment. Oh, damn. Shirazu's, Shurigen's, Shirazu-kun's, death will not be forgotten. Damn. Be safe, Mutsuki. That's so sad. Fuck. I really hope Mutsuki ends up being okay. Oh, and now we have... No! God damn it. I see Mutsuki tied up, and I see Torso. Wait, how did Mutsuki not defeat Torso? Was it the Takizawa interfere? Because there's no way. There's no way Torso's stronger than Mutsuki. We saw Mutsuki face off against Torso, I think, in a previous chapter, and Mutsuki wrecked Torso, if I'm not mistaken. So, and Mutsuki's pretty strong, so where am I? Good morning. Torso, I've waited for so long, and now you're mine. God damn it, fuck, guys. I'm not prepared for a sad chapter. I'm just not prepared right now. I'm really not prepared. I was so hyped to read this chapter, and now... Fuck. Land, this is our secret house. We're going to get married, you and me. Surprised? Holy shit. Mutsuki isn't freaking out yet. I was never able to find out why. Why what? I've got to get out of here somehow. Why I was so drawn to you. It's those eyes. They're like mine. If only I can move my arms. You, arms? Wait, what? Ah! Don't worry. You'll heal all right up. Oh, did he cut off her arms? Oh, fuck. Oh, my fucking God. Holy shit. What did he do to her arms? Oh, my God. No way. Oh, this hasn't hit me yet. Wait a second. Am I fucking reading this correctly? Oh, shit. He cut off her arms and legs. I think he cut off her arms and legs. And that's why she screamed, didn't she? Oh, my God. Okay. Oh, I don't know what to say right now. Holy fuck. Now you're mine. Fuck, I gotta read this again. If only I can move my arms. Arms? What? And then she screams, or he, or however you're gonna refer to Mutsuki. Don't worry, he'll heal right up. I worked so hard for these. Yeah, he definitely did cut off her arms and legs. Well, she will heal, so it's not the end of the world. But like, holy fucking shit, man. I can't believe he just did that. Yeah, Mutsuki's fucked, guys. The start of the torture. Shit! God damn, dude. That hit me right here. I definitely need a quick break, guys. So I'll see you in a sec. You know, my hair is just really not being cooperative today, so I apologize if it looks like crap. But then again, what's new? One more thing I want to say is, if I'd read this chapter like 4 weeks ago, I probably would have freaked the fuck out. And I still kind of freaked the fuck out. But like, after reading Berserk, that manga is just fucked up. Guys, it's just fucked up, so I'm sort of used to it by now, I guess is what I'm trying to say. Still though, holy shit. We'll be conducting a much closer investigation, so in the meantime, you'll be in Corniculum. Oh, this is Takatsuki. If results confirm that you are indeed a ghoul, why are they even bothering because you reveal a Kakugan, you'll officially be transferred to Cochlea. I read it. I appreciate it. The book, the story, what did you mean by all of it? What I said, this is an offering to the king, a symbol of hope for all ghouls. The Washu clan is cooperating with the ghouls. Okay, well now she just comes out and freaking says it. Okay, so now we know for sure. Any reader with a brain will be able to figure that out. I don't concern myself with those that don't have one anyway. Okay? One of my aims was to fan the flames of distrust against that family. The impetus for all of this was something I found stuck in the pages of the notebook my mother left me. Mother Ukina, in the notes she left me, wrote of an organization named V. In order to investigate the organization, she formed a relationship with my father, Kuzin, a member. But I am a surplus of that relationship. What is V? Okay, hopefully we'll find out more about V here. Kings of the Law, Arbiters of Chaos. They are known by many names, a conceited group that sits legs crossed across atop the throne. Sorry, I'm freaking out because we're learning some deep shit here. People that mistakenly believe this world belongs to them. Holy shit. Do you enjoy misleading people like this? Like what? With fairy tales, I mean. I don't blame you for not believing me, and I'm trying to at least lead you in a sense. Allow me to offer some evidence that this is not idle gossip. RC Gates, you've passed through one before, haven't you? Did the gate respond? It doesn't make any logical sense, does it? You have RC levels on par with or surpassing that of most ghouls. What say you? If you ask me, your body shouldn't have set off the gate. Wait, what? If you ask me, your body shouldn't have set off the gate? I'm confused. Okay, this honestly doesn't make any sense to me because I feel like it should say your body should have set off the gate. I'm not 100% sure. Maybe I'm just reading this wrong. Those things are designed to ignore RC cell readings that conform to a particular pattern. I see. Originally, this function was to prevent Kakuho-derived Kinkei from needlessly setting off the thing. However, there's one more RC cell reading those machines will not detect. That of a ghoul that belongs to V. Or those of Rize Kamishiro. What the fuck? Cells of my father, a V member, or mine, his daughters, and the child who has her Kakuho, Ken Kaneki. Holy shit. The woman who brought tragedy upon you was a ghoul that fled from V. What the fuck? Rize was a part of V? Holy shit. Was a ghoul that fled from V. Oh my god. Okay, tons of revelations. Holy shit. Rize. Oh, we're getting more Rize. Young girl, what are you doing? Did I manage to escape them? One must not sleep in the middle of the path. Have to run. I hungry. I guess this is how Rize and Shachi met. Okay, interesting. So I'm guessing that Rize is Shachi's like adopted daughter, if that makes sense. I guess he like took her in. Munch munch, your name. Rize. Okay. Here, books. I know not where you come from, but you need to make an effort to live. Study. Learn of your weakness, stripling. What's a stripling, huh? From now on, you have to take the name Kamishiro. I inherited this name from my master who taught me martial arts. Did you kill him, Shachi, your master? He died all by himself. One cannot best old age. Hey, Shachi, does this mean you're my dad? Okay, so this is how they met. This is good. This is interesting confirmation. I can't believe Rize was a former member of V. Rize, you've been overeating, haven't you? Be discerning. No satiety, yes, I've heard it 1,000 times. Shachi, doves in the 6th ward, a whole bunch of them. My foolish daughter, has she? I will go. Shachi captured, interred in Cochlea, I repeat. So I guess Rize somehow alerted the dove, alerted the CCG, and they came to the 6th ward and conducted some sort of investigation, and for whatever reason, that caused Shachi to get captured. And this is probably why he's pissed at her. It's Algiri, fighting in the 11th ward is a diversion. Okay, and this is how Shachi got broken out. Oh, so now we're revealing why Shachi joined Algiri Tree. It makes sense, actually, now because of everything with V that we know now. And also everything we know about Eto. Matsaka Kamishiro, I am Eto. I will lend you my strength. You want to see Rize, don't you? Kuzin. She called herself Eto, but I am currently with your daughter. I will watch over her by her side. In return, if something should happen, please take care of my daughter. Yes, I accept. Thank you, old friend. Oh, it's interesting. Okay, so Shachi is watching over Eto while Kuzin is watching over Rize? What? This is just... This chapter, the revelations in this chapter, everything's starting to fall into place. What is that? I shall exterminate. I will capture and exterminate Shachi. Oh, shit. Okay, are we going to get Orama versus Shachi? Yes, I accept. Sorry, I'm just going back to the previous panel and reading here. Thank you, my old friend. Okay, and there's Kaneki there, I think. There's Rize. Okay. And that's Arima with his Kinkei. Ah, and then I think that's Shachi screaming, "I will capture and exterminate Shachi." Okay, so next chapter we're probably going to get Arima versus Shachi, which is pretty crazy. I think that is it. All right, guys. Wow, pretty crazy chapter. A ton of stuff to break down. Damn. Okay, it's very interesting. That part at the end, that Shachi is taking care of Eto while Kuzan is taking care of Rize, is very interesting. And obviously, we have the connection between Rize and V, which is pretty crazy. But I'm going to go ahead and take a quick break, read through the chapter, and then bring you guys a short summary. I don't have time to do a full analysis today, and there's just too much to squeeze it all into one video, or one video with a live reaction, I should say. So I'm going to do a very brief summary and then go ahead and end it off. So I'll see you guys in 1 second. Nope, Torso, that's a bad idea. Last time a ghoul named Jason did that to a random innocent one-eyed ghoul, he created a monster. I agree. Horrible idea. Alright guys, so like I said, I don't have time to talk about the whole chapter in depth. I might release a video later this week doing an in-depth analysis if I get the time. At the very least, I'm going to talk about the situation with V at some point, because that's incredibly important. But the first and the most important thing in this chapter, probably, is the association between the CCG and V. We already sort of knew it from the last chapter, but I don't necessarily think that Arima is a member of V. In last chapter, we didn't know if the CCG was aware of Arima meeting with V for sure, but now we know pretty much for certain that the CCG, and specifically the Washu clan, are directly working with V. And what this sets up is it means that in all likelihood, and the way Eto was talking about how V sits, you know, cross-legged atop the throne of the world or something like that, I can't recall the exact words, but the way Eto was saying that means V is probably going to be the final villain. They're probably going to, we already sort of were speculating on this, we already sort of thought this, but now we pretty much know for sure, not for sure, I shouldn't say for sure because we don't know anything for sure, but in all likelihood, V is going to be the final villain. I mean, I made a theory earlier last year, about V, about the leader of V potentially being the final villain, the boss of the final villain, and I think that that seems to be coming to a front here, because Eto definitely doesn't seem to be the final villain anymore. I don't think Arima is either, because he's doing tasks for Kaiko, which indicates that Kaiko sort of has command of him. So I think the boss of V, whoever it may be, is going to be the final villain, and V as an organization as a whole is going to be the final villain. Okay, so the next thing I want to talk about is I want to talk about Eto's character a little bit here and her fate in the future, because we learned some interesting things about Eto in this chapter. So after this chapter is pretty much confirmed that Eto is not necessarily entirely bad. She's done some pretty fucked up things that I honestly can't forgive, like what she did to Takizawa. Even if she hates the CCG, and even if the CCG is working with V, what she did to Takizawa is just beyond fucked up and just like not forgivable. And also what she did to Kane was just like not chill, to say the least. But anyways, Eto seems to be working to take down V because she truly believes that V is evil. So a lot of people who have been thinking, you know, at least for the first part of the series and potentially even up till now, that Eto was A, the One-Eyed King, and B, the biggest villain in the series, the final villain, I believe that's pretty much like confirmed not to be the case anymore. If anything, Eto might end up working with Kaneki, and I can sort of see that being the final battle. Kaneki and Eto and maybe some more of Kaneki's friends and some older characters taking on V. Although we don't necessarily, Tokyo Ghoul isn't exactly your typical manga, so we don't know if there's going to be like one final villain or one final battle necessarily, but nonetheless, I do see Eto and Kaneki working together at some point to take down V. The next thing I want to address with regards to Eto is, what's her fate going to be in the upcoming chapters? Is she just going to be in prison for this entire Rue Island arc? Because it does seem like we're going to have a showdown between the CCG and Aogiri Tree, and probably V is going to be involved as well. And if Eto is locked up for this, for the entirety of this arc, Aogiri Tree is fucked. They're just fucked. Because, first of all, you have the entire CCG coming after them. Then you have the fact that V is involved. You don't have the strongest, who's probably the strongest member of Aogiri Tree. We don't know Tatra's level for sure. But we don't have Eto fighting for Aogiri Tree. So Aogiri Tree is just fucked. Like, there's no way they can win this. There's a 0% chance of winning this. Because in a previous chapter, I was saying that potentially the CCG could suffer huge losses because they didn't realize that Eto was, of course, the One-Eyed Owl. But now that they know, and now that they're locking her up, it's pretty much gonna be a slaughterhouse. I don't see Aogiri Tree being able to do anything unless something crazy happens, potentially Kaneki turning on the CCG, but we'll just have to see it. I suppose that maybe some other ghouls could get involved, like maybe the people from Monteku could get involved, maybe Kuzan could get involved, which would change things. And also the fact that Eto just wrote this book and probably has caused all the ghouls to rise up against the CCG, that could play a role. So I don't really know. It doesn't look good for Aogiri Tree though at this point. Okay, and the final thing I want to talk about is everything we learned about Rize in this chapter, because Rize's past has been very enigmatic thus far, but we got some pretty important things revealed. So first of all, we know that Rize is somehow related to V. We don't know what the exact relationship is. Perhaps she's biologically related, and this is just me theorizing here, but perhaps she's biologically related to a member of V, or maybe she's the daughter of a higher up in V, but nonetheless, she is related to V in some way. And then also at the very end of the chapter, we finally learn what the true relationship between Rize and Shachi is. And of course, Shachi is Rize's father. We also learn how Shachi ended up in prison. It's because Rize did something stupid to attract the CCG, and Shachi got kind of screwed over by it. It's also very interesting that Shachi and Kuza know each other. It's also very interesting that Shachi and Kuzan supposedly know each other. I apologize that this has been mentioned in the series before, but I did not realize this. I did not know the two know each It's also very interesting that Shachi and Kuzan know each other, because in this chapter it's indicated that they're friends. If this has been touched on previously in Tokyo Ghoul, then I apologize, and I guess I missed it. But this is news to me, and it's also very interesting that, of course, Kuzan is taking care of Rize, who's basically Shachi's daughter, while Shachi's taking care of Eto, who's Kuzan's daughter. And then lastly, next week we of course have Shachi versus Arima, which is going to be super interesting. Also, it's confirmed in this chapter that Shachi is double S, because I think it said at the very end on the last page that Shachi is a double S ghoul. A lot of people were thinking that he's now rated triple S, if I'm not mistaken. But nonetheless, we have Shachi versus Arima, and I really don't see Shachi winning this. Shachi is super strong for sure, but Arima is like undefeated. He's taken one cut in the entire series pretty much, and that was with in his fight with Kaneki, and Kaneki is super strong. So we'll just have to see it, but I really don't see Shachi beating Arima. I think it's going to be a pretty easy victory for Arima unless someone else intervenes. Potentially Kuza could intervene, actually. That would be an interesting fight. Kuza and Shachi versus Arima. I'd be down to see that. Well, alright, folks. That is pretty much going to do it for this video. As always, if you enjoyed, be sure to drop me a like down below and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already for more Tokyo Ghoul reviews and live reactions. Also, as always, be sure to let me know your thoughts on the chapter in the comments. As for my thoughts, I thought it was a great chapter, lots of information learned. I'm going to go ahead and give it an 8 out of 10, overall phenomenal chapter. We didn't really get any action in this chapter, except at the very end, we sort of got some action on. But great setup chapter for next week, where we of course will have Shachi versus Arima. Otherwise, I want to thank you again for watching, and I will see you in my next video.